Hello, and welcome back, everyone. Anthwolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as Ciaphas Cain here, my Jedi Knight. And where we last left off, we had saved the world of Tatooine there in the background by deactivating the Republic's shock drum project and saving Master QX at the same time. Kira, our Padawan, came out and admitted her Sith heritage to the master who found her, and we should be on our way now to the world of Alderaan to find the final Republic secret project. Before we do that, we're actually going to involve ourselves in a few other matters. So, we do actually have a couple of bits of mail. Yeah, why not? We have one from Lord Praven here. Everything I believed about the Jedi was wrong. After you defeated me on Tatooine, I surrendered myself to your order as I promised. Still not certain they would take me in. Yet they did, and I've begun my training as a servant to the light side of the Force. I have cast aside the trappings of my Sith past, and been reborn as a Jedi Padawan. I cannot undo the horrors I unleashed on the innocent, but going forward I swear to devote myself to halting the spread of darkness. And he sent us a blue mortal color crystal. Good for him. And this is Camus Orden. Oh yes, the former Circa employee. Today was the first day of his private testimony to the Senate regarding Circa's activities. The company won't be closing down, but they've been caused some trouble. And he sent us a bit of technology as a thanks for our good deeds. Might as well go quickly drop that off. Color crystal. Let's pop it over there for now. And back down to the planet of Tatooine. So yes, we're here to look at the bonus series of Tatooine. Something I've never looked at before for either the Republic or the Empire. But I think that's true for all the bonus series. So there is someone who would like to have a word with us here in the spaceport.
Your boy inside. We got 10 minutes before the wind picks up.
What about Chancellor?
She's not stupid. She'll be here. Just go. You should get inside, too. There's a sandstorm coming, and the spaceport's a designated shelter. No flights in or out for a while.
I've been on Tatooine a while, and I haven't seen any storms.
They mostly die out crossing the Jundan wastes. But when they hit hard.
Galen. Dozen more from the farmsteads coming in.
I guess we'll make room. Come on, they'll stay out of your way.
We'll be buried alive in here.
You'll be just fine. Don't worry. Well, looks like we got out okay. Pretty much everyone did. Though we lost 3 power generators. Doesn't compare to fighting. What was it, some Sith Lord causing ground quakes in the desert?
You're very well informed for a... What did you say your job was?
Name's Galen. I'm just a man enjoying his retirement, trying to give something back to the community. Look, these people have it rough in the best of times, but between pirates and sandstorms and sand people, we can't take much more. If you leave without finishing the job you started, how long before the Empire claims this planet?
You're asking me to stay, but I've done what I came for.
And along the way, you helped out all sorts of people. Would it hurt to focus on that for once? Tatooine's only chance is unity. Making communities that can stand together against warlords and monsters. Espelar's our best hope. It's a trading post where farmers, Jawas, and leaders from 6 towns swap information. The Empire means to burn it to the ground.
I'm sure Espelar is important to Tatooine, but I can't see why the Empire would care.
With a strong trade outpost, there's strong community and strong resistance. Without... Sandstorm broke Espelar's defenses, and the Imperials will send in saboteurs. You need to give the people breathing room, help them rebuild. Stop the Imperials, head into town, and help put this planet on the path to being a proud, independent society. Or give up and go. Your choice.
Wait. I can feel my arm being bent around my back there. Thanks, Galen. Trying to make me feel guilty again. Some people. I just saved the world twice over, you know. Literally twice over. I'm sure someone else with nothing else to do. To be fair, I've come back here in 3,500 years. This place isn't really a proud, independent, united community. In fact, the Empire's here as well, so, you know... If we left, nothing really would change. That's what I'm trying to say here.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Oh, let's head to this trading post then. So this trading post is somewhere just to the northeast here. If I had followed on, we probably could have brought T7. With the resonations of the shock drum no longer affecting the world. Oh. I mean, why don't you make that your trading post? It's a much more established, much more, like, more defensible. Huh. Deal with you in just a moment.
lightsaber, jerk.
Oh, hello. Oh, okay, so that... The saboteurs were setting up to blow up this compound, and yet the mayor of this community is over here instead. Ah, this place is, looked better as well. Ah, sand people. Well, that's certainly a problem. There's various vendors around here. Espelar. Okay, this is what we're looking for.
Hey, you're the Jedi Galen sent, right? Old man's kind of crazy, but he has his moments. I'm Mayor Aaron, and this hole in the sand is mine.
What do you know about Galen, anyway? He wouldn't say much.
Anchorhead's own volunteer politician. Does all the work, doesn't take one credit. Galen claims this little outpost is key to uniting the planet. I'd like to agree, but I've got other things to worry about. Sand people always follow the sandstorms, and there must be a dozen tribes out there. Plus pirates, broken equipment. It's pull out or be slaughtered.
Why do you and Galen think this outpost is so key?
The outpost builds trade. Trade builds community. Community builds a self-sufficient planet able to defend itself. Not fancy, but it's a start. Look around, and anything you can do, I'll be grateful. Until things clear up, though, I think you're our last visitor.
So similar to the situation on Taris, it seems. With their broken equipment and they believe the sand people coming close. they're expecting that they're going to have to pull out of this situation and leave the trading post behind. What we'll do is we'll take a small break here, and when we come back, it seems we're going to be trying to help out in the community. We'll see what troubles they have and how we could help this trading post become somewhat self-sufficient and able to defend itself. Thank you all for joining me though, of course, here with more Star Wars The Old Republic. As always, feel free to leave a comment if you so wish, and hopefully I'll see you for more next time. Until then though, take care. Bye bye now.